I'm Alia Tavakolian.
And I'm Bob Sullivan. And this is Beyond the Breach. Okay, so we're sitting around trying to figure out what breach we should do for season two. And there's a lot of candidates, but Equifax keeps coming up and we keep saying, no, that's boring, everyone knows about it. What more is there to say? And then we talked to Ron Lieber, New York Times columnist. He was at ground zero of the Equifax hack when Equifax stopped answering the phone because they were so busy and overwhelmed. Ron was basically providing customer service to New York Times readers, to everybody. And so we talked to him about it, and that really kind of turned the tide, right? What did you think when you met Ron?
Ron brought the Equifax story to life for me. Like, the way he just dropped me in the story immediately was so amazing. Ron describes how he and his colleagues at the Times talked all the time about how if something like this were to happen at Equifax, it would be the mother load. And then it happens, and Ron gets the email in his inbox that the mother load has happened at Equifax. And it's at the worst possible time because his father is dying in Florida. It's during Hurricane Irma, and he has to get there, and he's trying to get from Chicago to Florida, and it's the drama, Bob.
The drama's real, though, right? I mean, you see Ron, you hear from Ron talking about writing stories at 2 a.m. from a hotel room, not knowing what's gonna happen with his family or with his readers. But this is true for everybody. When one of these hacks occur, there's never a good time. When is a good time to sign up for credit monitoring or go to some crazy website and enter your social security number and find out what's happened? So talking to Ron, I think, really convinced us this was the story to do.
Yeah.